Good evening, students. Today we are going to study a C program to print the pattern of numbers. Consider this problem given to you in the exam, say a pattern of numbers like this. On the first row, there is one digit 1. On second row, digit 2, 2 times. On third row, digit 3, 3 times. On fourth row, digit 4, 4 times. On fifth row, digit 5, 5 times. Now, how to print this pattern? For this, we have to write a C program. We will start with the header files, hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h. Then we will write the main program line, that is void main. This will open the program, curly bracket will open the program. Here we declare the variables required in the program. That is I and j, I for rows and j for columns. Clear screen will clear the screen. Now see how the outer for loop is written in this program. If you see the pattern, there are 5 rows and 5 columns. It means we need to take a loop for rows where it starts with 1 and it ends with 5. So which indicates there are 5 rows. And there is another loop, j, in this program, which is responsible for printing the numbers. But how many times we want the numbers on every row? That is I times. Because if you see in the pattern, on first row there is only one number, on second row there are 2 numbers, on third row there are 3 numbers, on fourth row there are 4 numbers, on fifth row there are 5 numbers. So the number of numbers are increasing according to the row number. That's why we write a condition into the j for loop as j equal to 1, j less than equal to I, j plus plus. In that we'll write a printf line like this, percentage d, and we'll mention I here because we wanted to print on every row the row number that many times, row times, correct? So here this loop is responsible for printing that digits on every row. And this line, printf line, after completing printing the values on a particular row, to go to the next row, we use this line, that is printf slash n. And this is the closing of the outer for loop. Getch will hold the output symbol on the screen, and this closing bracket will close the main program. Now we'll see the handrun, how this code will going to actually print our pattern. We'll start with the outer for loop where I value is 1, condition is true. Here j loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 1, j plus plus. It means one time this code gets executed and it will going to print the value of I here, that is 1. It means on the first row it will print 1. When j becomes 2, the inner condition becomes false and it goes out of the inner for loop. So this line will shift the cursor to the second row. From here it goes to increment the value of I. Now value of I becomes 2. It means second row started. On second row, j loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 2, j plus plus. And here it prints the value of I 2 times. The current value of I is now 2. So this loop gets executed twice. It prints 2, 2 on the second row. After that, this shift the cursor to the third row, I value gets incremented by 1, I value becomes 3, it means third row started, the condition is true, the j loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 3, j plus plus, and it will print the value of I 3 times. So if you see on the third row, it prints 3, 3, 3. After completing this task, this line shift the cursor to the fourth row, where I value becomes now 4, condition is true, this loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 4, j plus plus, and it prints value of I, that is 4, 4 times on the 4th row. Then this again shift the cursor to the 5th row, I becomes 5 on the 5th row, condition is true, j loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 5, j plus plus, this will print I value, that is 5, 5 times on the 5th row After completing that, this line shifts the cursor to the sixth row and it increments the value of I by 1, that is now 6, and the condition becomes false here. When I value becomes 6, the outer condition becomes false and it stops the execution of the outer for loop. By this, it prints the above pattern. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Okay, thank you.